Recently, Amazon released the Kindle Scribe, which, like most other Kindles, you can read books on it. But what makes it special is that you can also write on it using a pen. But not only that, you can upload PDF files to it, which you can edit, write on. But also, these PDF files can have links or hyperlinks within them, which make them very special because it means you can jump about from page to page. So, in the example I'm going to show you how to create today, we've got this calendar here. So you could click on a month, which would take you to the monthly calendar. You could then click on a particular day, go to that day, write your notes, and then you can click on a link, which you can take you back to the monthly calendar. And from there, you can go back to the yearly calendar. So this opens up a whole realm of possibilities for creating different types of PDFs. And these could be things like planners, diaries, prompt journals, kids' educational books like handwriting books and puzzle books. And there are a lot of uses for these as well. You could maybe give them away. If you've got a newsletter list, you could give them away in exchange for an email address. If you're a coach, you could give them away to clients. But what I find particularly exciting is that you can sell these on platforms like Etsy. And we can see these publishers here already doing that. But you could also sell them on platforms like Gumroad or even your own website. And another thing you could do is you could create these for customers on sites like Fiverr or Upwork. So you could offer a service whereby you could create personalized or customized versions of PDFs for customers to upload to their own devices. And you can use these not only on Kindle Scribe, but you can use them on other e-paper devices like Supernote and Remarkable, and also on tablets on apps like GoodNotes. So I'm going to show you how to create one of these for free using the free software Canva, and I'm going to show you how to add those links or hyperlinks to the components within the PDF file. So if that sounds interesting to you, then follow along. Now, if you've not been to this channel before, then welcome. My name is Paul Marles, and I do videos on how to make it, keep it, and grow it. And that's your money I'm talking about. If you do like videos like that, then please do give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and smash that notification bell. Okay, so we're going to go straight into this. And as I said, we're going to be using Canva. Now, there is a free version of the Canva, and there's also the paid version, which is the pro version. What I'm going to show you today, you can do in the free version. And I'll leave a link to Canva down below in the description. So first of all, we're going to click on Create a Design, then Custom Size. Then we're going to change the units to inches. This is very important. Then we're going to put in the width 8.5 and then the height 11. So it's going to be an 8.5 by 11 inch document. And here we have our first blank page. So over on the left hand side, make sure the design tab is selected. Then we're going to search the templates and we're going to put in yearly calendar. Now, if you scroll down, I'll show you which one we're going to choose today. Now, you'll notice some of these do have a little gold crown, which if you hover over, it says Pro. So you can only use these particular templates in a paid for Pro account. All the other templates that don't have that little gold crown, you can use in the free account. So continue scrolling down and we're going to choose this one here. So just click on it and it will put that into the blank file. Now we're going to change some of these elements on this page. So first of all, we're going to delete this beige colored box here. We're then going to left click of the mouse, just drag a bounding box around all the components on this page. We're going to change the text color to black. And where it says multiple fonts, just click on the downward arrow. And then we're going to change all the fonts to this one here, which is Now. You can choose any other font that you like if you prefer something else. So this is our first page. So now we want to go to Add Page. So for our next page, we're going to put in a monthly planner. So just put in monthly planner. Again, you've got all these to choose from. I like this particular one here, which I'm going to click on. So we've got one for each month of the year. So for the first page, we're going to have January. I'm going to then click on Add a Page. Click on February, add a page, click on March, and so on. I'm not going to go through every month of the year, otherwise this video would take far too long. But if you're creating this yourself, obviously you would just add a page and add that month until you got to December. So we're going to go to January. So we're going to make some changes on this page. First of all, we're going to click on the background and hit delete. Then we're going to get rid of that year. Where it says January, just click on there. going to change the font to now after January, just add in 2023, and then just increase the width of that box so that it all appears on the same line. So now we need to change the text on the rest of the page. So first of all, on this box here, just click on this little button in the corner to highlight the whole box. Click on the font selection box, click on now. And then the same for this area here where we've got all the days of the month. If you click on it and it just highlights one box, and just click on that little button in the corner, it will highlight all the days of the month. Again, click on the downward arrow on the font selection box and click now. So there we have our first month. And so you'd have to go through each month of the year, just changing each individual page. I won't bore you with that. I'll do that quickly now. Okay, so I've done that and I've got the 3 months here, January, February and March. As I said, obviously you'll have all 12 months there. Now, what I suggest doing is just adding a title to each page, which is going to help with the linking later on. I'm just going to put in yearly calendar there. This one I'm just going to write in January, February and March. Okay, so the next thing we need to do next is add in our daily pages. So again, click on add page, go over to our template selection area. Now for this, I'm just going to type in lined paper and I'm going to choose this one here. Again, it's a free one. And we're going to remove this line here. So we just select it, hit delete. Now the beauty of this is that we've got this bar here with each month of the year already filled in, which is going to be very useful. So we're going to select that and I'm going to rotate that through 90 degrees. We're going to drag that over to the right hand side and then I'm just going to drag downwards and increase the height of that box. Next, we're going to add some text at the top of the page. So left hand side, hit text, hit add subheading, drag that up to the top. And we're just going to type in 1st January. Click outside the page and then just click on that box and then just drag it into position. So it's aligned with the left-hand side of all the lines on the paper. So this is our first page. Now, we can just go ahead and duplicate this page and save us having to go through all that process over and over again. But what we need to do before we do that is add in the links here on this right-hand box for each month of the year to correspond with each of our monthly calendar pages. So click on where it says Jan for January. Then the right hand side, you're going to see this link button here. So click on that, then scroll down. And now you can see we've got those pages that we've already titled. So you'd click on January. Now what you'll notice is that Canva gives this link an underline. So you can either keep that there or you can remove it. I'm going to remove it. So here at the top where it says underline, just click on that and it removes that link. Next, click on February, go through the same process. Scroll down, click on our February page. Click underline to remove that underline. Click on March, exactly the same again. Click on our March page, remove the underline. And again, you would do that for every month of the year. So now when we duplicate our page, it also will duplicate all those links as well to each month, so we don't have to go through the whole process. So reduce the size of that page and then just click on the duplicate page button. So now we've got our next page here. All you need to do is change the name of that. In this case, 2nd of January, and align that. Click on duplicate page and again, change that 3rd of January. And then just move that to align it. And again, you would have to go through that for each day of the year. Yes, it's 365 pages. It is a bit tedious, but that's what you've got to do to create these products. So now what I suggest doing is when you create each daily page, just also add the page title. So for this one, 1st of Jan, 2nd of Jan, and so on. So now we want to link each day on the monthly calendar to our individual pages. So again, just click on the day and you can see the box is highlighted. Right hand side, click on link and then just go to the corresponding page, in which case this is 1st of January. Remove the underline, next day, link, 2nd of January, and so on. So now next, the last thing to do is then just to link each of the calendar months to its corresponding monthly calendar page. So what you need to do is just drag, left click of the mouse and highlight all the days of a particular month. Then at the top here, hit group to group all those together. So now we've got this box outlined in this purple line. So what we can do, if you don't see that link box in the top right hand corner, just click on these three dots here where it says more, and then click on link. And again, we'll get all the options here. So this links to January. So just click on that, click on done. And we'll do the same for each month. So once you've finished, you'll have all 12 months of the calendar monthly pages, and you'll have 365 pages of each day. Next thing we need to do is actually download it to our computer. So top right, hit share, then hit download. And then in this drop down list, you've got all these options here. Now for this, we don't need to select PDF prints like we would if we were creating, say, KDP, no content, low content books. Instead, we can choose PDF standard and then just hit download. And that will download it to your computer. Now to upload this to Kindle Scribe, I've actually got an app downloaded called Send a Kindle on my computer. So I'll just open that up. And it's very simple. All you need to do is just drag that file into the app, and I just click send, and it will send that across. So if you're using SuperNote or Remarkable, the upload process will obviously be different. If you're using something like GoodNotes on an iPad, the way I do it is I would upload that PDF to my iCloud and then open up the GoodNotes app and then just open up that file from my iCloud. So let's have a look at this file on the Kindle itself. So here is the one we've just uploaded. We'll open that. And here we've got our calendar. So we could test this. Just click on the month of January. Yes, takes us to our monthly calendar. Click on February. Again, yes, that works. And click on March. Again, that works. Now, what you could do is add a link maybe somewhere up here that would take you back to that yearly calendar. But for now, we'll just swipe back. Now we'll go back to January and test each day. So we'll click on the 1st of January. Yep, that takes us to the right day. We can click on this link, takes us back to our monthly calendar. Let's just try the 3rd. That's great. We can write notes on here as we wish. And let's just test one of these other links on the right hand side. So let's go to February. Yep, that works okay. So you could use this technique that I've showed you in Canva to create your own PDF files for whatever you wanted to do. Now, if you wanted to do something like a puzzle book, you could create that PDF file of a puzzle book. You could then import it into Canva, then put in your editable links or hyperlinks, and then download it with those links and then upload it to Kindle Scribe or Etsy platform or wherever you decided you're wanting to sell these types of files. Now, if you're new to this channel and want to know how to go about making things like KDP books to sell on Amazon, these are journals, diaries, planners, etc., then I've got this playlist here which shows you how to create these types of books and upload them to Amazon. Thank you much for your time. It is very much appreciated. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and until next time, goodbye.